Hey, what's up everyone, and once again, welcome back to Super Smash Bros. Melee. Or as the announcer actually says, Melee! I don't understand why he says that. Like, if you let the intro play, he's like, Super Smash Bros. Melee! And I'm like, that's not how you say it. Anyway, so last time we played through Adventure Mode with Tyrannosaurus Allen, Yellow Yoshi, and this time we're gonna be playing through with Kirby. I didn't actually pay attention, I didn't go back and look what palette swap we used. I feel like I will have used this one last time. So I'm gonna go with this red one, because you can hardly see his mouth or his cheeks, which is kind of odd, but whatever. Alright, I need to turn my TV up a bit, actually. I can't hear this. Because I was actually, playing a couple matches to see between this and the last episode, just to see if I could get any better at the game. And no, I couldn't. Now I'm curious. Yeah, with Kirby you can just eat all of these enemies, so I believe you can do the same with the re-deads in the Zelda level, and you just spit them out as a star, so could be useful, I suppose. Can't reach that guy, but I guess if any get in the way, I can just eat them like this, although, ooh, is that a super mushroom? That is a super mushroom. Does this give me any more eating power? No. But I can just, like, oh, Birdo trophy. I can just knock them out of the way. I think the Birdo trophy, it's either the Birdo trophy or the Pidgeot trophy. Pidgeot being the little guy on a, like, magic carpet from, is it Mario 2? I think it's them, or it might just be the, I think you actually have to unlock them to unlock one of the stages or something like that. Or get those trophies to unlock, I think it's the Mushroom Kingdom 2 stage? I could be completely wrong, but I know that they have some significance, in the game, so, yeah. Also, this is gonna work fairly well on these Yoshis, isn't it? Because not only do I hit them on the way up or on the way down, the shockwave is actually hitting them as well. And because these guys are incredibly weak, it's actually KOing them. So maybe that'll work on the Kirby team, so we can actually fight Giant Kirby. The one time we can fight Giant Kirby is gonna be the time where I'm playing as Kirby. I hope that actually is the case, and I healed myself just to take more damage there. Can I eat this? Nope. I think it's in Brawl that they introduced the ability for Kirby to eat items, which I think is a very welcome addition. I didn't know this in the background, though. There's actually like a Mario Golf style area, which is, that's pretty cool. All aerial? Did I only attack with aerial attacks? Is that what that means? I doubt that. That's probably not what that means. Let's eat Peach, get her Toad ability, which is actually just a counter. I think I probably showed that off in the Peach Classic Mode playthrough. I more than likely did. But I'll try to use it here. There we go. So basically, if they attack me while I'm using Toad, I will counter their attacks. Alright, I'll take this fan. I'll take this fan. Mario actually just fell off and Kirby lost his jumps. Okay. Sir, go away. I have a parasol too. I'm gonna hit you with it though. Blam! Fubber! Okay, there we go. And another parasol. I'm not gonna risk that because I'll probably end up dying. That's how this works, isn't it? I start doing good, and then I have one little screw-up, one teeny tiny little screw-up, and it causes me to lose. Or lose a life. I've already lost one life, and we're on, like, the third level? Yeah, this is the third level. We've got Mushroom Kingdom and the, I guess it's technically the second stage, because it's the Donkey Kong part as opposed to the Mario Brothers part. But it's the third thing we've actually done so far. Anyway, I want to actually steal these guys, there we go, give Kirby the giant punch. Let's charge this up. How he even swings that arm around, I have no idea, because it's not even really an arm. But it KOs these guys in one hit, so I'll happily take it. Game! Alrighty. What's up next? Is it Zelda? No, I forgot about Giant Donkey Kong. I actually want to talk about Kirby's, changes, like I have done with the rest of the characters. I think Mario's maybe the only one I didn't, because that's before I really thought of the idea. Do the side smash! Okay. Okay. Okay, I'm alive. Stone, thank you. Get uppercut, kicked, and I should have just left him there, because he was actually falling off with the crate. Can you die already, Donkey Kong? Jeez. Did I not eat you already? I guess I tried to spit him out last time. Come on now. Oh, but you've died so easily the last times. No, that's not gonna do it either. Okay. But yeah, like I was saying in the Yoshi part, that's essentially what Yoshi's up smash has turned into in the in Smash 4. I'm gonna take that and punch you! There we go. The audio track looked really weird there. I was just, it's like a bunch of different, like little peaks. It's kind of weird. Underground maze, here we go. I knew Zelda was next. I just forgot about giant Donkey Kong. But yeah, Kirby changed a lot from, like, well, I guess not a lot, but from Melee to Brawl and then Brawl to Smash 4. His dash attack in Melee is, of course, this, which is, I guess, based off of the fire ability that Kirby gets in his games sometimes. I would assume that's what that's based off of. Like, if you eat a fire type enemy, he will get the ability to like, go along the ground, and I believe in the air. In fact, more often than not, in the air, using this kind of a move. So, I'm guessing that's what that is based off of. In Brawl, he actually that move changes. And can I eat the Reeds? I'm gonna try eating the Reeds. Can I eat you? I can eat you. Hello, Mr. Saturn. In fact, no, you can come with me. In Brawl, it's replaced with like a. He like stands on his hands and spins around, so it's kind of like a cartwheel, but kind of not. Because he, like... I really don't know how to explain it. Can I just, like, get past this guy? Yeah, there we go. Can I eat the like-like? I want to know if I can eat the like-like. Come on, like-like. Yes, I can eat the like-like, okay. Kirby can just eat anything. Yeah, there we go. But yeah, it's changed into, like, a spinning on his hands kind of kick, which is kind of difficult to explain. So, like, he doesn't do a cartwheel, he spins around sideways, but he's upside down and hits people with his... feet, essentially. His special moves have remained almost the same, except for his hammer move. Side B here, which is, of course, hammer. On the ground, he just does one simple swing, which I cannot initiate. Yeah, Zelda likes to do the down tilt. Oh my god, stop! What? How did you hit me then? You're not changing into Sheik here. You need to stop. I don't... It's something about these CPUs. They're just able to get more hits in than I am. Okay. Go away! Okay, you know what? Come down here, Sheik. Come down here. God, why are these characters not dashing when I'm hitting dash, which is just slamming on the control stick to the side? They are refusing to dash, they refuse to roll, and they refuse to smash attack. I don't know what it is. Is it just a lot easier to do in Smash 4, and I'm just incredibly used to that at this point, because... There we go! Because it's just not working especially well. Anyway. Whew! Yeah, on the ground, his side B is the simple straight-up hammer swing like that. I believe in Brawl it's the same, except it's, like, more powerful? Not more powerful, I think it has, like, a shorter range. But maybe it's a little bit more powerful, I'm not entirely sure. And then in the air here, Kirby does that, and... Oh, what does he do in the air in Brawl? I think in Brawl, he does essentially that, except he spins around, like, twice. So this doesn't exist after Brawl. And I never found much use for that anyway, to be fair. And then in Smash 4, it's changed completely. You can actually charge up the hammer, which is fairly useful. And after a while, he starts taking damage from it. But if you unleash it, it's ruddy powerful, basically. So, I find it the best in Smash 4, because you can actually, if you have tap jump, or if you, like, align your fingers in a weird way, you can actually jump while using it, and kind of jump towards opponents, and sort of confuse them a bit, I guess. Because it's not really something you'd be expected to do, because it's not something that can easily be done without either using tap jump, which I know a lot of people do turn off in Smash 4. Because you can turn tap jump off, which I probably would do, but I find myself using it a considerable amount, surprisingly. Mainly just for footstooling, because jumping off of people's heads, footstooling, is something that was introduced in Brawl. And I find it more easier to... I tend to just do it by accident when I'm going for an up B, and I just accidentally do, like, the tap jump. And if you don't know what I mean by tap jump, I mean push up to jump. And I just end up doing it by accident, and... you know, footstool people, so it's pretty useful in that regard. But, I don't know. I don't know why I got into the topic of tap jump. But you can, like, move around in Smash 4 with the side B if you are either able to use the tap jump, or if you So I use my thumb and then I move my, because I use my thumb to jump on the X button. So if I use my thumb on the B button and then I go to do the, I use my index finger, I move my index finger from the Z button, I was about to say the G button. Oh god, that didn't work! Onto the Y button, which is the top jump button, because I use GameCube controller in Smash 4. Oh, bye! That worked. And that's just kind of the way I do it, but I guess you can use Tap Jump as well, but I find it kind of awkward to use Tap Jump. Alright, moment of truth. Are we going to get to fight Giant Kirby for the first time? I'm going to gonna stand at one side and attempt to hit them with Final Cutter over and over again. Which seems to have worked so far. Come on, come over here. I'm going to need you guys to come over here. You want me to fight Giant Kirby, which you probably don't. Oh god, oh god. Nope. Yeah, yeah. We got like 9 seconds. Did I do it? I did it. I think I did it. I think you have to get it in under 30 seconds. Yep, there he is. Giant Kirby. And he's so happy. So that's all you have to do to fight Giant Kirby. I'm fairly certain that if you are playing as the regular colored Kirby and you fight Giant Kirby, he's probably going to be Yellow Kirby, because Yellow Kirby is generally the second player. Although, is Yellow Kirby even in this game? I think he is, but eat that. Oh, don't eat that, because I wanted to use it. Venusaur, not bad. Oh god, bomb! But yeah, he's a giant character, like Giant Donkey Kong, so he's going to take a lot more taking out. Oh, Charizard, I'm dead. Don't you taunt me. Get stoned! Or don't, because you probably wouldn't be allowed to play Smash if you were stoned, because can't have the characters being stoned now, can we? Samurai would not approve. Base Lord Samurai. Alright, Corneria. But yeah, as far as I can remember, I think that's the only ways Kirby was changed? I think? I don't know. Maybe his inhale ability got a little easier to use or had more range put on it or something, but I'm not sure. Anyway, we're fighting Chicken Fox right here. You want this? No? You want this? You want to stop being a chicken? Go away. I don't know if I died first there. I did die first, damn it. Well, I mean, we both died. I don't know if it, like, counted it or whatever. Or if it was just like, yeah, you're gonna die, so you're gonna have to redo this. Okay. I wanna try something, because this fox is not even resisting. Come on. Let's just go over here. You go a bit further. Oh, he's gonna run away. Get back here. Fine, this is gonna make it easier. Get in my belly. Bye-bye. Oh, he broke out. I figured he was going to break out, to be honest. Okay, ba-bomb. Come on, Fox. Get boomed. Oh, that... Get boomed? Apparently that worked, even though he shielded. But I'll take it.
Fox, we've come to help. Looks like you've taken a beating. Hang on. We've got the enemy on our monitor.
I'm guessing we're not going to fight Falco for a while. Since we just don't seem to be fighting him anymore. No, there's Fox again. Maybe there's some certain conditions you have to fulfill to get Falco to appear. I'm fairly certain it's just random, but I don't know, I could be wrong, I suppose. Okay, you're gonna come over here. I'm gonna try this again. Yeah, see, that time he died first. I love doing that with Kirby. That's one of the most satisfying kills you can get. That's actually something that was removed in later games. You can still do the throw next to the edge, but Kirby won't jump off the edge in the later games. I think it's based off of his suplex power, which is one of the abilities you can get in the Kirby games, so I'm fairly certain that's what that throw is based off of. Oh god.
Cyndaquil, please!
Cyndaquil and Staryu, brilliant. There, I made it through the
Hiya-ee!
Okay, so they basically encourage you to use the Pokeballs here, because your attacks, they're not like as weak as regular team battles, although stones seem to work. Okay, come on, come on. What just appeared? Was that a Scizor? I think that was a Scizor? I don't know what it was, because there's nothing. Oh, it's a Wobbuffet. Raikou, hello! I was like swallowing then, and I was like, not able to say Raikou straight away. Okay, stop. Yeah-y. Alright, Raikou did a decent amount there. Chansey is going to give us more Pokeballs, or more eggs that will turn into Pokeballs, I believe. Oh, they're actually acting as health items. Although that one turned into a Pokeball. Was that an Electrode? If that was an Electrode, I didn't see the Electrode, so... fun. It killed me. Okay, Porygon 2 did all that. And I think either Porygon 2 or Scizor sent Chansey flying. Alright. Alright, F-Zero Grand Prix. I didn't really talk much about the Grand Prix when I was playing as Yoshi, did I? I just remembered that. I was just been rambling on about something else. But yeah, I think Kirby's a fairly fast character. Look at him run. He, like, transforms his, hands into ears. At least that's what I always used to think he did.
Get off the edge!
I didn't need to do that. In fact, that slowed me down, but I felt like just showing off, I guess. Alright, let's zoom in again. Oh god, maybe I shouldn't try to not say. Can I just do this? Nope, they don't care about my stone power. But it did launch me a bit further forward though, so hopefully this should give me a little bit more time. I think you can duck beneath them as Kirby. This is probably very risky, but I'm gonna try it. You totally can! Wait, I think you can just stand up as Kirby. Are you serious? Do they just jump over you there? Maybe it's that only that section.
Just run for it! This is a mistake! Jump!
I don't care, I finished it. I thought it was gonna kill me because the camera didn't follow. Sometimes the camera's like, you know what? No, you're gonna die today. You're gonna die today. And it doesn't follow you. I want your Falcon Punch. Now I'm gonna use it against you. Okay. You're clear. Bye then! Oh my god. We are getting some amazing just... character stupidity finishes in these. That was a really fast match against Falcon. Because he, you know, killed himself. Alright, come on, Ness. Oh, I forgot that that doesn't last quite as long and you can't charge it. Alright, you know what I'm gonna try? You know what I'm gonna try, sirs? Come over here. I'll just throw Mr. Satin at me. Go away. That clearly didn't work, but you know. It was worth a shot. Okay, come down here. Oh god, Kirby, please. I didn't mean to do the dash attack. Yeah, they're just going for Mr. Satin. They don't even care. They just throw it at the wall. They don't even care what happens to Mr. Satin right now. I've got an itch. Come on.
No, don't get run over, Kirby. Oh my god.
I didn't have time to jump. That's what I mean about this game. It feels a lot clunkier now I'm playing it again after Smash 4. I know it's not. It's supposedly the most precise Smash Brothers. But honestly, Smash Wii U is my game. Smash Wii U is my favorite Smash Brothers game now. Alright, come on, dude. Come on. I kicked you, Mr. Satin. What are you going to do about it? Oh god, that might have been a mistake. Come on, Brozef, don't die. Oh god, he's not dashing, he's just like strolling. Okay, this is going badly. You want to fight with Mr. Satins? Is that how you want to do this? Is Kirby's up throw good? I seem to remember Kirby's up throw being good. I also seem to remember that I'm going to die. Up throw. Nope. Ness, please. Up throw. Not very effective.
It's super effective. Super effective.
There. Okay, come on. I was expecting to see the little, like, line thing, like the heartbeat meter thing that appears in Smash 4 when you're about to KO someone. But no, this isn't Smash 4. Get out. Is that gonna do it? That didn't do it. Back air! Back air!
Forward throw!
Please kill Ness.
No, I'm scared. Please, stop. Leave me alone.
I'm trying to shield with L because the trigger on my right trigger seems to be not as responsive as it used to be. Probably because I've used it so much in Smash. Come on! You didn't move over. God, go away. Just leave me alone. Stay away from me.
I don't know the rest. Nate wants to battle the Five Nights at Freddy's parody. There we go.
Oh god, that was surprisingly stressful. I'm hoping we don't fight Giga Bowser, because we fought him last time, even though I used a continue. So, clearly you don't have to, doesn't matter if you use continues or not. Can I eat this guy? Oh, he left. doesn't love me anymore. I'm curious if I can eat the polar bear. Oops. Get my revenge on the polar bear from the Mario run where I was like, I need to stop picking fights with polar bears. Okay, so I can eat the topies. I believe topies are actually seals in Japan. As in like sea lion seal type thingies. But they were changed to these little ice type creatures, and I can eat the polar bear. In America and the UK, Europe's because of seal clubbing, I believe. It was like a thing where people club seals, and they were like, nah, don't want that, bro. So they changed them to these things. Redead! Kick you towards the screen, apparently. Don't need to go near you. I have an itch on my nose, so if I was just jumping straight for a bit there, it's because I was taking my hand off of the control stick. To try to itch my nose.
Go.
Come here.
Go away.
Come here.
Go away.
All right, that way. Okay, Nana's over here. I believe there's a way that you, like, competitive players who play as ice climbers, they can, like, desync the ice climbers to have them do two separate things, and it's really cool. It's insane the amount of stuff these people can do just by exploiting the game. So, definitely look up some competitive ice climbers battles, because it's very interesting to see. Because they essentially just desync them, and then whilst Popo is like grabbing and attacking an opponent, Nana's sort of jumping in and doing the forward air from behind. It's insane what these people can do. But it's really cool to watch. It's not something I'd ever be able to do, because clearly Melee is not my game anymore. But it's just very cool to watch, so I recommend you check it out. Any competitive Melee video, well, any competitive Smash videos, but especially competitive Melee. The competitive Melee players are insane at what they can do just by, like, exploiting tiny things in the game, like, you know, like wave dashing and all of that fun stuff that I attempt to do and can only really do on slopes. Alright, come on, die. There we go. My voice, like, died when I said die. That wasn't pleasant. Alright, I may be able to get these guys in my mouth and then throw them out to the side. Although I'll have to get them away from each other first. No, he broke out with... Oh god, I was just... wasn't even pressing B. I pressed B once when I was on the stage. And then he's just like, you know what, I'm going to continually use this even though you are mashing the crap out of the A button. I don't feel like helping you out right now. I'm just going to keep on doing the inhale, which is what I want to do. I'm not going to let you recover and you're going to die and have to do the fighting wireframe match all over again. Because this game just hates your very existence. Simple as, sir. Simple as... Please leave. Oh god. Oh god. Oh, okay. Coughing, that's nice. I just ate. That might be why. Maybe I've got something stuck in my throat. Alright, come on. Fireflower's gonna do me no good. You gotta get out. I found the upward slash does the most. Okay, I'll eat you then. It'd be kind of cool if it gave you, like, Zelda or Captain Falcon's ability, because that's what these guys are based off of. Pick that up. There. Alright, and you can recover. I forgot that the fighting wireframes can actually grab onto ledges, because the Miis, and I believe the alloys in Brawl, cannot grab ledges, so... This is pretty stupid. If you knock those guys out to the side, they can't recover past their second jump. So, they're not recovering, basically, if you knock them out to the side. Alright, let's try this again. So Mario broke out of the throw immediately last time, so I'm going to try that. And that is exactly what happened last time. We're going to get inhaled, and then that's going to happen. Yeah, there's no way that's happening anytime soon.
No, you don't need that.
I don't think he did need that, actually. I don't think I've done any damage to him. Jeez. Okay, what just spawned over there? Home run bat. I will take it. I'm used to the home run bat because I've been using it in Smash 4 challenges, because you can actually get equipment in that game that allows you to use the home run bat or constantly have a home run bat whenever you start a match. So, come on. Come on. There we go! Metal Kirby, don't care. Alright, final D. And you know what? because it's Final Destination, it's the final match. We've got 3 stocks, because I died twice. No, 6 times, I suppose. We're gonna try this. Let's try the suplex move.
Hoo-ya!
Oh. Welp, Bowser broke out of that, clearly. Oh my crap. Okay, we're gonna try something else here.
Yep!
There we go. And Bowser actually died first because of that. I do not even care. Sacrificial KO. It actually got me points. Not bad. I think I must have a setting weird on my TV, because Kirby looks a different color than what he does in the Elgato software. Interesting. Only a slight different color, but I guess my TV is just brighter than what's in the recording, than what's actually coming through from the Wii. Sorry. Sorry about that. I'll admit, I was yawning. I was trying to disguise the yawn by making it sound like I was just going, oh, I accidentally paused it. I want to see what this is. It's Nintendo. Maybe we should go to... Let's go to Nintendo.co. I'm going to do that right now. Let's do it right now. Nintendo.co.jp/smash. That's not how you spell smash. Smash. Let's see where this... See if this is still a thing. This webpage is not available. You lied to me, Melee. I don't care what you say, you lied to me. You lied to me! Damn it.
Congratulations!
Look at Ness's face. He's like so shocked. Wait, is that the same image that we got in Classic Mode? I'm not sure. Possibly. Alright, we got the Kirby Trophy. Let's go take a look at said Kirby Trophy. I need a drink, I'm gonna cough again. Kirby. Kirby's small size lets him dodge many attacks. No, it doesn't. But his lightweight makes him fly far when struck. Using his ability to inflate, he can jump 5 times. His swallow attack creates wild combos. Not only can he copy foes' moves, but he'll also put on special hats and mimic their voices. His hammer is unwieldy, but powerful. Alright, B is swallow, and smash B, side B is hammer. I thought that it was called inhale. I guess not, maybe that's in later games. Anyway, oh, we've done this 6 times. I guess it's when I was doing the challenge for beating it on very hard or whatever. Next time, on Super Smash Bros. Melee, before next time, I'm going to take a drink because I keep needing to cough. We're going to be playing through Adventure Mode once again, this time with Fox McCloud. So thank you all for watching, make sure to leave a like and a comment if you enjoyed, and I will see you guys next time.